The best feeling in the world is when you go on to Adobe Audition to try to make a commentary, and all of a sudden, the neighbor starts mowing the lawn just a few meters away from you. Also, Mark Bergevin, please stop doing these things when I'm in the middle of my beauty sleep. I went to bed so late last night playing GTA Online. Those MC Business double sales are really getting to me. But we have ourselves some Canadiens news that I really wasn't expecting to see at this time. It's Cam Hillis, a guy who got signed to the Montreal Canadiens for 3 years on an entry-level contract. You know what's really funny? The first reply here on Twitter on the Canadiens post when they said they signed Cameron Hillis, the first reply from Connor underscore 779 says, 3 years for a kid with no NHL experience? Okay, lol. Obviously, he's most likely being sarcastic and joking around, but I thought that was a funny thing to throw in there, just trying to get the laughs out here. So, of course, again, apologies, this happened 7 hours ago. I just woke up. It's like 4 p.m. here on the West Coast, which means it's 7 in Montreal, which means I'm going to be incredibly late. But Cam Hillis is a guy that I was honestly expecting the Montreal Canadiens to being able to sign. If you were keeping up with our little Canadiens prospect talks, you'd know that when it came to signing prospects and taking a look at the guys that need contracts, there were pretty much three that were in a bubble together. It was Cam Hillis from the Guelph Storm of the OHL, it was Cole Fonstad of the Everett Silvertips in the WHL, and it was Allan McShane from the Oshawa Generals in the OHL once more. When it came to these three, they were all kind of in the same bubble, where they were Montreal Canadiens picks in the middle of the 2018 draft, and they all were at the point in their careers where, hey, they're 20, they're leaving junior, they kind of need to be signed now. And for the most part, because the Canadiens are in a weird spot where they have so many people in their system, there was a common idea that the Canadiens would only really be able to sign at least one. Cam Hillis was the guy who had the best production out of the three, and he's the guy who has the most improvement over the past few years among these three. Cam Hillis, in his draft year, had 59 points in 60 games. Then in his draft plus one, he was riddled with injuries, an unfortunate drop-off to 22 points in 33 games. But this past season, he absolutely started to get things together a little bit more. As the captain of the Guelph Storm, he posted up 83 points in 62 OHL games. Among all the Canadiens, let's just say, second-tier prospects, he's the guy who probably has the most expectation, especially in comparison to McShane and Fonstad. McShane, a guy who didn't really improve, statistically speaking, over the past few years, and Fonstad, who actually had a little bit of a similar year last season compared to this season. It's just kind of interesting to see the deployment and the way these prospects are progressing. But when it comes to Cam Hillis, I see somewhat of a middle six NHL projectability out of this player. Obviously, that's not like a Cole Caulfield or Alexander Romanov kind of projection, but for a guy that the Montreal Canadiens were able to snag up with a third round pick, it's certainly not bad. You could definitely get much worse than that. So for Cam Hillis, next season, I would honestly expect him to be a mainstay in the Laval middle six, if not bottom six. If they're willing to give him an extended role, then hey, by all means, give him a top six spot in Laval. But for a guy like this, obviously, I'm not going to say, oh, I expect him to make the NHL right away. I'm not going to be that guy that Connor 779 is making fun of in pushing this guy towards being an NHL talent right away. But Cam Hillis, if I can see him realistically becoming an NHL player, I'd say it probably happens within the next 3 years, but next year is a little bit too soon. We'll see how he adjusts to Laval and the AHL soon enough, and once we get done with a year of that, we will see where he is development-wise. As for the other guys, McShane and Fonstad, I really don't know what's going to happen with these players. If their rights get traded to other teams for picks or for other players that the Canadiens can actually actually use in their system. I could honestly see that happening, but with the way the Canadiens' numbers are laying out, where they have so many people to sign, so many people under contract already, and so many prospects to sign later on, it's certainly a weird predicament that Marc Bergevin has gotten himself into. For more on that, check out the video talking about how the Canadiens' plan was ultimately screwed by the current events in the world, but for now, it's Cam Hillis' time to shine. The guy is a Montreal Canadien under contract. I hope you enjoyed this video, and bye.